G'day everyone, CJ here.
This trip is a drive to explore a newish road to ETS2's Iberian Peninsula DLC, the Portuguese IP8 from the A2 through Beja to the Spanish border, then the N433 to the A66. This exploration is a part of a trip from Lisbon to Seville. My driver is in a northern suburb of Lisbon off the A1 past the airport. He is at the Kolico factory with a trailer of lemonades. His destination is at the Cesta depot in the northern suburbs of Seville, just a little way off the E5. He is ready to go by 14:55 on a mostly sunny afternoon. He leaves the Kolico and makes his way to the A1, where he turns south. He goes past the turnoff to the A12, instead taking the IP7/A2 past central Lisbon and over the Ponte 25 de Abril crossing of the Tagus. The road gradually turns east, past the A33 and the A12. Eventually it splits with the A6. It goes south to south-east, past the Sines turnoff and Grândola. After about 170 kilometres into the trip, it reaches the IP8 turnoff to the east. Here we start on the new to ETS2 section of the IP8 as it goes roughly east-southeast 52 kilometres to Beja. It is late afternoon as our driver passes through Beja and nearly sunset as he crosses the Guadina. The IP8 continues to the Spanish border at the Barranco de la Raya crossing where the road becomes the N433. From Beja to the A66, it is about 182 kilometres. The route ends the new to ETS2 section as it turns onto the A66. This goes south 30 kilometres to the western edges of Seville. It goes past a junction with the A49 before crossing the Guadalquivir on the Ponte Rey Juan Carlos I and passing the turnoff to the A4. The way turns north, following the Guadalquivir before exiting on a road parallel to the A8083. The route makes a big curve north under the highway and goes into the Mera Sevilla Centro Comercial to the Cesta Depot. I let the tired driver park it at 0112. He gets €22,927 and 688 XP for the trip.
Okay, we're going to head down towards central Lisbon, pass a by, cross over the big bridge in the bay.
Stay back.
most lovingly designed. Slow down a bit. Lemonade in the back. Bottles crushing, or even aluminium cans crushing. So what's been going on with ETS2? Well, we've had some updates from SCS. They've been talking about the rework of Austria, which was pretty good. That's for the next update. They're still working on part of Russia, although they must be worried about a reduced amount of revenue due to this war going on. And that's a shame. There are rumors they're working on, like, the Slavish regions of the map. So that's some of the ETS2 things going on. Once they've redone Austria, I hope they do Switzerland next, because Austria, it looks like they've got the Alps and that showing up really well for Austria, and it'd be a shame if they didn't do that properly for Switzerland as well. Okay, we are coming up to a toll booth. Yeah. and we'll go to this one. Faster going the other way, but it's longer. So earlier today I finished the challenge where you deliver to all the ports in Iberia, and the last one was to Lisbon, which I thought I'd already done. Turns out I'd actually picked up from there. Okay, this is all new road over here since the last update. It's been a while. It's definitely time-like. Did some, actually worked on it. Goodness me, how long have I been driving around without lights? Ever since the last service, I'm sure. Vicious sides to the roundabout.
Exit now.
Show discovered. Woo! I'm not going to wander through the town. I'm just going to drive on through. Sopa. I think we're in Hispania now. Thank you. dust gets settled. Zafrata Huevla.
Thank you.
roundabout. Take the second exit. Exit down.
Strike the main North South Highway sooner or later. Probably a bit sooner than later. That's it there. Just got to get onto it. So we're going south. Trees. over the river. Okay, we're getting closer to Central and Seville. That last turnoff was down towards Algeciras and Gibraltar Bay. Cesta, which is where we've got to go. There's the delivery point up there. So, lemonade delivered from Lisbon to Seville. We went the interesting way, and it took us 551 kilometres and 9 hours 21 minutes of game time. We got 22,927 euros and 688 XP. Well, I hope you enjoyed that particular trip. Until next time, CJ is out.